Welcome to Mihao Motors, and today I wanted to talk about the new 2024 refreshed Ford Maverick. I wanted to talk about some of the new colors that they got, some of the new standard features that they have included on some of the trim levels. But most importantly, I just kind of wanted to go over the build sheet of the one that I just placed an order for. So yeah, let's get started. So the original Maverick that I placed an order for back in August was the XLT. I had it in Atlas Blue with the 2-liter EcoBoost, all-wheel drive, tow package. I had it equipped with the XLT luxury package. That gave you some like LED box lighting and the it's like a 400-watt inverter, and heated seats and a heated steering wheel and the trailer hitch. The one thing it also came with was like a hard drop-in bed liner. It was like made out of plastic. So that was an additional feature that was in it. I had the 4K tow package, which gave you a 7-pin connector and the trailer hitch. Really, the only other options that I chose on that XLT was the power moonroof as well as the floor mats. So in November, I ended up contacting my dealership and changing the entire spec sheet of my car. I changed the Maverick from an XLT to the Lariat. And the reason for that is there's a ton of features that the XLT, as great of a price bargain it may be, because I'm going to be using the car for basically everything, and it's going to be my full-time driver, it's going to be my commuting car and my like do everything car, I ended up thinking that the options that I was lacking, actually I'd be pretty mad about in the long run if I'm going to keep the car. And I'm just going to get into some of the options, but I'm just going to go through my build sheet first, and I'll kind of touch upon the options that were missing from the XLT. So the first thing was paint. I ended up keeping the same Atlas Blue. Like I said, I've wanted a blue car, so the Atlas Blue color is what I'm going to keep. I still kept the same engine choice, the 2-liter EcoBoost with the 250 horsepower, 275 torque. In the Lariat, you only have the option for all-wheel drive or the advanced four-wheel drive. I stuck with the regular all-wheel drive, the advanced all-wheel drive, only available in the Tremor. I didn't want the Tremor. I thought it was a waste of money for me. So I stuck with the regular all-wheel drive, stuck with the 8-speed transmission. So the big thing right off the bat was the Lariat 500A equipment group. So all the Mavericks are equipped with LED headlights, incandescent taillights, incandescent third brake light. The Lariat gets signature lighting. You get like a C-shaped lighting on the front, daytime running light, instead of having the regular orange turn signal halogens. In the back, you get, again, a C-shaped ring around the taillights. You get a larger 6.5 screen instrument cluster with some like configurability to it. You get intelligent access. So you get push button start. I was didn't think twice about it until I really thought about it and started driving my own car after the dealerships. After a couple of months, I realized how convenient a keyless entry and keyless start is to a car. You have a noise reducing windshield, power sliding rear window, which you cannot get in any of the other trims. There's pros and cons to it. I just think it's cool. You get ambient lighting, which is the color blue. It's only the only color it's available in, but the XLT and XL don't have any sort of lighting inside whatsoever. So it is pitch black in that car. And then the other thing is automatic and dual zone climate control. In the Lariat, you get it. In the XLT and below, you do not. So a couple other things that you should be aware of with the XLT versus the Lariat. The Lariat, you get an awesome upgraded Bang & Olufsen sound system. It's got like 8 speakers and a subwoofer. It's a beautiful system. It sounds great. It's really deep. I still listen to a lot of music, take a lot of phone calls in the car during work, during all my driving. So that was a big thing for me. So the Lariat is also equipped with the Co-Pilot Assist system, which is different than the Co-Pilot 360. This gives you that traffic stop and go assist, which allows you, basically the car to drive itself. It's not fully automatic, but that's a big thing that you get. It also gets active steering intervention and things like that. So those are things that you get with the Lariat. So moving on, packages. So the car that I end up ordering, there's a couple of packages you could get. There's like the FX4 off-road package. It's more of a style package, in my opinion. I know that you get like a better oil cooler and some like dark rims and bigger radiator and a cooling fan, things like that. And skid plates, as well as some drive modes. But in my opinion, it's $800. I will never be taking this thing off-road more than, maybe on my lawn to spread mulch. There's zero reason for me to spend the $800. There's a black appearance package as well. It's like almost $1,650. Again, not worth it in my opinion. So the Tremor off-road package, that kind of goes, I touched upon it earlier in the XLT and why I didn't choose it. In my opinion, it's $3,500. I will never be taking this thing off-road. There's no reason for me to have it. You get some tow hooks, some better departure angles. I don't see the need for it. It's $3,500. It's almost 10% of the cost of the car. It's not worth it, in my opinion. I equipped my Maverick, just like the XLT, with the 4K tow package. This was one of the main reasons for wanting a truck. Comes standard with the luxury package, as well as the standard Ford Co-Pilot 360. So the Lariat comes equipped with like aluminum, brushed aluminum look, 18-inch rims. Another couple of reasons why I didn't want the FX4 or the Tremor package. The Tremor package rims, they have like a little orange coloring to it. I was okay with that. The FX4 package comes standard with these black rims. I personally never appreciated black rims on a car. You could swap them out. They have another set of 17-inch, they're like a machine face carbonized gray aluminum rim. It's like $800. I don't want to pay for it. So on top of paying for the FX4 package, you got to pay another, $800 just for a set of rims. All right, from there, we have the exterior options. So you have some splash guards, bed divider kit, toolbox left and right. Those things I didn't bother with. I don't really need them. I'm not a contractor. Oh, bed cover. So on the Ford website, they have a couple of bed covers, one of which there's these tonneau covers, I guess that's how you pronounce it. One's a soft folding, one is a hard tri-fold, and one is a hard roll-up. So I ended up going with a soft folding. Not from Ford, though. I went on Amazon, and for $160, you could get a soft folding, or if you will, soft roll-up tonneau cover from just any sort of site. They clamp down on the sides. You got a gasket on each side. It's locks into place. Works just like this for, let's see, about almost a fourth of the cost. So, my opinion, not worth getting this. Does the same thing, holds up against snow, keeps rain out. That's really what the point of these tonneau covers are. The trifold is like almost $1,200. There's a hard roll-up cover that is $1,200. In my opinion, those are not worth the money. The trifold, you will always lose a third of your bed. The whole idea of a bed is to just put stuff in there with an open roof. Trifold, you can fold once, you get a third, twice, you get two-thirds of the pickup, but then what? Then you're stuck with this third. You either see at the back and have two-thirds of your truck, or don't see at your back at all. To me, it's not worth the cost. It's too much money for a tonneau cover. Next is a TouchLink bed lighting system. It's $320. The Mavericks are all, at least the Lariat and the XLT with the luxury package, you get bed lighting anyway. You click a button on the passenger, driver's side of the tailgate. It's rubber. It is, comes standard with the car. It's LED. It's bright. It illuminates the whole area. Plus, you get the bed lights by the third brake light. So there's really no point in getting this. It's $320. It gives you two sets of lights on the passenger side with a separate switch. Dealer installed option, not really, no point in getting it. There's a bed extender. I don't, you could get it if you plan on having some stuff in there. I personally don't see any need in it. Maybe I'll get one to like haul wood or maybe things like that. I don't know. So the cars, this Maverick is specifically equipped that comes standard with a spray and bed liner. Like I said earlier, if it came with a hard drop-in like the XLT did, I would swap that out and get a spray and bed liner anyway. It's like $500 to do a third party. For charging you $495 for it, it's an appropriate cost. It's worth doing. In the Lariat, it comes standard. You can get a bed mat. It's $140, total waste of money because you have a spray and bed liner anyway. The next option is like a Ford Protect film for the hood and fenders. All my cars that I've had, they were always sedans, and their hoods got basically sandblasted from the amount of driving that I do on the highways. In this case, I was thinking actually about doing this, maybe like a 3M, which was like third party, or like a one of those like Invisa shield things. I thought about doing it and then realized that this car sits a lot higher than all the other cars that I've had. I'm not doing it. I'm going to take the risk. It's not worth it, in my opinion. The next option for $150 are window air deflectors. I've had these before for one of my cars, and I found that they actually make more wind noise than it's worth. So you can use them for rain to like kind of like vent some of the, your air, but I don't know. It's a waste of money, in my opinion. I've never had good luck using them. Cargo bed net, $75. You could get one on Amazon for like a third of that. Totally recommend. Have it set up, hook it on either side across your bed and the very back to put groceries and things in. That's totally worth doing. The Maverick comes standard with some tie down brackets and things in the Lariat. Tailgate lock, I'm still investigating whether or not to do it. It's $40, and it's a dealer installed option, so when the truck comes in, I could like choose to do it or not. I might do it, but I'll have to talk to the dealership. I'm not really familiar. It's apparently to like prevent them from stealing your tailgate. I think probably what it is just an extra set of bolts, like your wheel locks. That's probably something like that. Speaking of wheel locks, you could get them equipped, $75. Definitely worth doing depending on the area that you live in. Engine block heater, it's $90. Again, depends on where you live. Northeast over here in New Jersey, it is winter currently, and we have no snow, and it's like 45 degrees. So winters have been mild, and I don't travel into like Canada or anything where it's extremely cold. So an engine block heater is probably really not worth it. The last couple of options are some hood deflectors, which are like clear or texture smoked. That's similar to those like the hood protective films. I'm not going to do it. It's $140 whether you go one or the other. I don't know. It's not worth it. I don't think it's worth the money. And your car ends up looking like it's got a mustache, and I don't really want a car with a mustache. The cars look ridiculous with them. So I don't know. Maybe it protects and maybe it doesn't. I think the car looks like it has a mustache, and I don't want a mustache in my pickup. One of the last options for the exterior is the security code keyless entry keypad that Fords have been notoriously equipped with forever. And notoriously is a condescending word, but more so famously. Those keypads are really, really cool, where you can lock your keys in the car, go do what you have to do, click two buttons, and get into your vehicle. I have been thinking about doing this option, but I've never been in a situation where I need to lock my keys in the car. So it's a dealer installed option. So if I wanted to, I can, upon the retrieval of my vehicle, be like, hey, just install this. But as of now, I really don't, I don't really see the point in it. All right. So the interior now. So Lariats are all equipped standard with this desert brown, they call it an active X interior. It's like a leatherette. The interior is actually really nice. The seats are comfortable. It's a really nice material from what I've heard. It's been holding up pretty well. You have two options for the interior colors. It's that desert brown or it's a black onyx. The black onyx can only be equipped with the vehicle if you have that black appearance package. I spoke about it earlier. It's like $1,600. in my opinion, it really dulls out the interior of your car. If you want to do it because you don't want the oranges and the navy blues and the light blues and the grays and that whole mismatch of colors, definitely worth doing if you want to tone down the interior. I personally like the whole mismatch of colors. It makes the inside of the car really exciting. I've always had dark interiors in my cars, so except for one, which was beige, and I didn't like that beige, and I don't ever want a beige car ever again. For the interior options, we don't have too many. You got a commercial assist kit, a regular roadside assist kit, a first aid kit. One option, though, that I was determined to get, and I mean determined, is the power moonroof. The power moonroof is an option that I've always had in all my cars and I use religiously. In the summer, in the fall, in the spring, I always have my moonroof open. And for $1,000, I am determined to make that happen in my Ford Maverick. Remote start system comes standard in the car. Smoker package, again, I don't need that. 400-watt inverter for the cab and the back bed comes standard with the Lariat. So the last two areas that you could choose options for in this car is the radio and the audio system. So the XLT is equipped with a standard Ford system that's got six speakers. It sounded okay. The better option in this case for not really that much money is the Bang & Olufsen sound system with eight speakers and a subwoofer in the Lariat luxury package. So that is a radio audio system that I have equipped in the one that I ordered. The nice thing about the Lariat, which I overlooked when I originally ordered the XLT, was the fact that you don't get a Sync 3 or like an actual Sync 3 system in the XLT and below. With the Sync 3 system for the Lariat, you get Sirius XM, which I listen to religiously. In the case of the Maverick, it doesn't really matter because you have Apple CarPlay, so you could just use the Sirius XM app in your phone. But I listen to Sirius XM a lot, so I'd prefer to have it just run through the audio system in the car. It just makes it easier because then, you're not draining the data from your phone. The other thing that I actually appreciate, and most people don't like, but I actually like it, a built-in navigation systems. I actually like them because anywhere you go, they always work. With a phone, you risk, especially because I travel a lot to like the mountains and go skiing and, this and that. I have found that my phone sometimes loses connection, like most people's phones do when you get to those interesting areas. A factory navigation system never loses signal. I've never had a navigation system lose signal, and that's why I like them. It has traffic and traveling, pitch to zoom, and it's I played around with it, and it's an okay system. So that is the Ford Maverick that I built. Atlas Blue, 2-liter, 4-cylinder EcoBoost, all-wheel drive, 8-speed transmission, Lariat with the luxury package, comes standard with the Ford Co-Pilot 360 and the 360 Assist program or package. I equipped mine with the 4K tow package, kept the standard aluminum rims, comes with standard with that spray and bed liner, some tie down points. You get a full size spare, which is exciting. My Maverick will be equipped with the desert brown interior, those ActiveX seats, power moonroof, which was an option, remote start, those 400 watt inverters, Bang & Olufsen sound system, Sync 3 with all the associated parts. So the Ford Maverick Lariat, standard base price with no options, $34,855. The options that I chose, which was not that many, they equaled $1,740. Destination chargers, which were almost, the most expensive option, which you can't get rid of, is $1,600. Coming to a total price of just over $38,000. So that is my 2024 Ford Maverick Lariat build. That is my build sheet, my total final price. Comment below, let me know what you think.